Jacques Cousteau said it best when he said people protect what they love and they love what they know. And here we are, literally in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. There's no one around us and we don't know what's underneath us. We're making the map as we travel. And then as we travel and make the map, we're picking spots and going down and looking at them for the first time.
We're here really to explore the deep sea. We're here to understand that some fundamental questions we have about how life exists and how biodiversity is formed and maintained in the deep ocean.
As much as we're able to see on this month-long voyage, we're going to see a very tiny fraction of a percent of the ocean that's left unexplored.
Beautiful!
In recent years, we've realized that there's a great diversity, a biodiversity of life in areas beyond national jurisdiction, where no country really has any control or reign of law. And what we're trying to understand in these areas is what the biodiversity is and how we can impact and communicate to decision makers and lawmakers, the world, to understand what's in these areas and the resources that are there and how we can manage and conserve these resources and use them.
As our human population grows and as our planet becomes more fragile, the health of the oceans becomes ever more important to our own state of being and the planet's. The high seas are the last frontier. They are this last global common space. Don't think of it as a small area. It's huge. It's like roughly half the planet. And because they're owned by no one, protecting them is really hard. There's no mechanism to do that through most of the legal infrastructure that each country or the world has. And so for almost 20 years now, people have been talking about protecting the high seas, but it's not that simple.
To protect something, we've got to understand what it is we're protecting. So we've got to know what's on these seamounts. There are resources in these places and beyond natural jurisdiction. And what we're realizing now is that there's genetic resources, marine genetic resources is what they're called. This is the genetic complement of an animal to be able to live in its environment. It's the full suite of genetics and genes that will code for biochemicals that we could use in pharmaceuticals, cosmetic industry, the food supplements. Even the answer to how they're going to adapt to climate change is in the genetic material of these animals on these seamounts we're studying.
Those are some of the questions we're trying to chip away at on this cruise, trying to understand how these organisms do what they do in the deep sea. There's a lot left out there that's unknown. And I'm pretty excited about what we're gonna find.